My interest in sanatoriums started when I went to Khoja Obigam, a sanatorium about 2,000 feet above sea level in the mountains of Tajikistan. Picture one of London's many huge council estate blocks on top of a Swiss mountain, and you'll have some idea of what the place looks like. By sanatoriums, I mean state-funded health spas that were built during the Soviet Union, so that after working hard during the year, down a coal mine or an assembly line, workers would have the chance to rest and recuperate. The idea was that after a week or two of fresh air, healing mineral waters, treatments such as carbon dioxide baths, workers would return more productive than ever.
Мясо там, например, салатики, это каша, например, только гречневая. Это для диета.
Питание хорошее, хорошее. Диета, это диета стул.
Brutalism to Stalinism, these buildings are some of the best examples of Soviet architecture, debunking the myth that architecture during this time was both homogenous and uninspiring. But plenty has been written about the history of these sanatoriums, and there are also plenty of photo books about decaying sanatoriums. The book we want to create isn't a history book, nor is it ruin porn. For me, what's interesting is that many of these sanatoriums exist today, sprinkled across the post-Soviet space, from the vineyards of Georgia to the steppes of Kazakhstan. And while some of these are being renovated, many have been largely preserved in their original form, stuck in a kind of time warp, offering the same decor and the same treatment the guests would have received decades ago. But who knows how much longer they'll be able to survive. The idea for the book came from my trip to Khoja Obigam in Tajikistan, where I spent a few days in April 2015. I was blown away by the architecture and landscape, charmed by the unusual treatments, and warmed by the hospitality both of those working there as well as guests. During the days, I did pretty standard stuff like swim or go to the sauna with a group of Tajik women, but I also had some pretty strange treatments, such as the ominously named electrical hot chair. My evenings were spent dancing, singing songs, and reciting poetry with other guests, which felt a world away from London.
В общем, замечательный доктор, стоматолог этого санатория, молодой, красивый и грамотный доктор, восстановил мне мои зубы.
Я балдею, ванна жемчужная, ванна, я от нее балдею. Там ванну ложись и бьет тебя со всех сторон, все лечит.
When I came back, I couldn't get that experience out of my head. So I decided to send a pitch to Fuel, a publisher in London. They were keen on the book, so I then got in touch with six incredible photographers to work with. They are Yegor Rogolov, Dmitry Lukianov, Claudine Dury, Michal Solarski, Olya Ivanova and Rene Fitzek. Since then, we've been researching sanatoriums tirelessly to bring you a selection of the most architecturally striking in the most stunning locations. So we have a publisher on board which takes care of the design and publication of the book, but we need your help to get to these sanatoriums in Russia, Belarus, Tajikistan and beyond, so that we can interview those working there, as well as guests, and to take photos that will hopefully inspire you to travel to some of these places yourself. We have a range of rewards, from small to big, and any help would be greatly appreciated.